Trump saves Roger Stone. Stone lied to cover up Russian involvement in Trump's campaign to protect Donald Trump. 7 felony convictions.
I am the law and order candidate.
We all knew how this corrupt story was going to end. Richard Nixon was never going to go to jail on Roger Stone's back. As long as the MAGA pretend gangster in the White House is in charge of the legal apparatus, expect more skirting of the law. We are subject to natural law and the penalties that follow when it is broken. However, in Trump's America, his detractors face the full weight of punishment, and his criminal cronies like Roger Stone get their crimes wiped clean. As the New York Times reports, on Friday evening Trump issued a statement announcing his decision to commute the sentence of his criminal crony Roger Stone. Stop him from facing the legal consequences of a jury finding him guilty of felony crimes. Crimes that were not so coincidentally related to Trump's campaign for presidency. From the moment Stone's guilty verdict read out loud in court, they began setting the table for this moment. Trump and his enablers attack prosecutors for being excessive and unfair. When that didn't stick, they turned their fire on the judge, accusing her of being an Obama appointee with ulterior motives to hurt Stone because of his connection to Trump. When the jury foreman spoke up to defend the judge and the process, Trump accused her and members of the jury of being Trump haters who wanted to punish Roger Stone. Ahead of the announcement, Stone had signaled his confidence that the head of the crime syndicate occupying the White House would reward him for not ratting. He knows I was under enormous pressure to turn on him. It would have eased my situation considerably. But I didn't, Stone said. This latest FU to the rule of law from Trump and his crime syndicate administration came less than 48 hours after the Supreme Court, including his two lackeys Brett Kavanaugh and Neil Gorsuch, kicked him in his big orange ass after his stupid legal team argued before the courts that he's essentially above the law and should not be required to hand over his taxes to investigators in New York or Congress. When the courts finished stomping on his orange head, they threw his legal team out with this scorcher. In our system of government, as this court has often stated, no one is above the law. That principle applies, of course, to a president. Yikes. Roger Stone's sentence was commuted because there's a corrupt Republican president in position to do so. Folks, this was a straight-up mob-style transaction. Speaking of mob-style, late Thursday afternoon, after Jeffrey Berman, the now-fired U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of New York, was done telling the House Judiciary Committee about the ways the Department of Justice functions under the command of White House personal injury lawyer, cover-up specialist William Barr, the committee released Berman's opening statement. It is an altogether remarkable document. In discussing the circumstances of his departure, Berman explained that, under Barr, the DOJ pretty much functions like a scene from The Godfather. Berman, who was appointed by Trump, his office is investigating Trump goofy attorney Rudy Giuliani over potentially running afoul of foreign lobbying registration requirements over his dealings in Ukraine, some of which prompted Trump's impeachment. Berman is also holding the evidence in the case that named Trump as individual number one, including other crimes. Trump wants to make these cases disappear, Berman not willing to roll with the corruption, and therefore Trump wants his own appointee gone. So corrupt Bill Barr concocted a quid pro quo scheme to get Jeffrey Berman out of the way so Trump golfing buddy Jay Clayton can take over as the head of the office, most likely to investigate and prosecute Trump for various forms of felony grifting. Berman describes to the House Judiciary Committee his meeting with Bill Barr. The meeting took roughly 45 minutes and was held in the Attorney General's hotel suite. It began at approximately 12:10 p.m. on June 19th. The Attorney General's Chief of Staff, Will Levy, was present with me and the Attorney General, but he did not speak. There were sandwiches on the table, but nobody ate. I responded that I love my job and my colleagues at the Southern District and that I was thankful every day for the privilege of being part of that office. I asked the Attorney General if he was in any way dissatisfied with my performance as U.S. Attorney. He said that he was not at all dissatisfied. He said the move was solely prompted by Jay Clayton's desire to move back to New York and the administration's desire to keep him on the team. The Attorney General pressed me to take the Civil Division position, saying that the role would be a good resume builder. He said that I should want to create a book of business once I returned to the private sector, which that role would help achieve. He also stated that I would just have to sit there for 5 months and see who won the presidential election before deciding what came next for me. The Attorney General said that if I did not resign from my position, I would be fired. He added that getting fired from my job would not be good for my resume or future job prospects. Folks, the Trump administration is a crime syndicate. This was a straight-up mafia-style transaction to once again crap on the rule of law. When you combine this corruption and criminality with the administration's disastrous coronavirus response, the Mike Flynn and Roger Stone case, the constant firing and muzzling of federal watchdogs, most people never thought they would see America turn into a third-world country ruled by criminals. Good thing America's going to flush this toilet in November. But we cannot forget the criminal enablers who could have stopped this, but consistently chose to greenlight the corruption and lawbreaking at every turn.
Every time they had a choice between America and Trump, they chose Trump. Every time they were called to the service of this nation and their sacred oath, they chose Trump. Every time. Learn their names. Remember their actions. And never, ever trust them again.
I remember everything.